it is important to realize projects like artistic and cultural projects in public spaces of Eastern Europe because the spaces there or like urban cities there are still in a transition process between post-communist and neoliberal condition, and there are still many gaps and empty spaces which could be used by artistic means and in a purpose to establish a new relation from the citizens to their living environment.
Actually, those practices can use everyone, and this book is kind of manual for doing something in the city. For change, urban environment, society.
So, the initial rebellious protest movement in Skopje that started in 2014 escalated into a mass protest movement that was called Color for Revolution. And it involves thousands of people who were mostly protest against the government politics and the corrupt system in the country. So this peaceful movement actually covered all public institutions from Skopje governmental project 2014 in multicolor paint. And the participants were using artistic means in order to express their anger against the Skopje 2040 governmental project.
So there is a very strange tradition in post-Soviet countries and also in post-Soviet Russian countries about whitewashing of the trees, the bottom part of the trees in springtime. And it was a real mystery for us. And we, with the artist Anton Kapustin, made a very huge research about all this. And we collected nearly 20 or 25 hypotheses about it and try to investigate what hypotheses are true or not. And we understood that none of them are true, actually. And if something, some of them is describing about the trees, okay, what to do with the lampstands, for example, because they're also painted in white paint. This is some kind of social ritual which shows the readiness to, and the order, you know, like the order and preparing for the new year. Like we start a new year with the order and cleanness and something like that. And we thought that there is a very interesting technology which is called Kantik in Russian army. So soldiers are forced to make everything very linear. And we call this project Kantik. So, and we wanted to take this technology like for renovation of the city. So we choose the abandoned spaces and I don't know, very dirty spaces. And we made this white line, like putting all these destroyed objects into an order, you know, like symbolical order.
The 14th district is a collaborative project between Metasitu and the 86 Urban and Urbanism and Film Festival. And it took place in the city of Slavutich in Ukraine and requires a small historical contextualization because the city of Slavutich was built following the catastrophe in Chernobyl to relocate people who were affected, but also for the liquidators and so on. So they had to build the city in 18 months, and the central government asked different republics to contribute with the district. So they brought in their materials, workers, master planners, and built a district. So Slavutich has district of Riga, district of Yerevan, district of Baku, 11 altogether. So what we proposed was to create a new district based on the city of Athens. And it was somehow an exercise of translating one urban context to another. And for the project, we invited through open call five locals from Slavutich who would conceptualize this new district. So our thinking group, that's the core of the five locals that took part in the project, came to Athens for a week. And we looked at the city from different scales, trying to unpack what it does consist from and how can it relate to Slavutich. Like Slavutich, who has 30-year history, and Athens, who has actually 3,000 years of history. And the final outcome of the project was more of a conceptual outcome. And so the thinking group, after spending 1 week in Athens, what they really wanted to bring back to Slavutich was seeds of chaos, a disruption, a sort of a new possible scenarios that can emerge spontaneously in this space. Today, the 14th district is a myth.
I see the potential of the network in realizing new interdisciplinary projects in public spaces of different East European countries. We started here in Berlin.